topics. Topics on the hill. All you need to know
about NCU.
Come learn about your school. And be in the know about your current affairs. If there's ever a time that you're in doubt, Topics on the Hill is here.
Listening to Topics on the Hill.
Topics on the Hill is here. Topics on the Hill is here.
Listening to Topics on the Hill.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another season of Topics on the Hill. It is the debut episode of season 4, and we are so happy that you are here. I'm Tristan Grizzle, and joining us this season, well, at least for today, we have a very talented individual. We have an effervescent... should I continue? I'm not going to continue. I'm going to allow her to do the honors of introducing herself. You can go ahead.
Thank you, Tristan, for the excitement. Hi, everyone. I'm Trisha Gay Kelly. I'm sitting in for Amoy today, hoping that I can make her proud. Yes, Amoy, if you're watching. Yeah, I'm trying a thing here.
You're going to do that.
Thank you. Topics on the Hill is a vidcast that was created for the students by the students. Now, we want to ensure that you know that last season there was no set schedule for the show. However, this season, the show will be aired every fourth Thursday at 6 p.m. right here on NCU TV Jamaica.
And of course, we want you, our viewers, to keep up to date with the affairs of Topics on the Hill. And so we invite you to visit our Instagram and TikTok pages at Topics on the Hill. And also subscribe to our YouTube page at NCU TV Jamaica. Now, coming up in today's episode, we'll be having an interview on the do's and don'ts of work and travel. The do's and don'ts of work and travel. We also have our Stars on the Hill segment, our Meet the USM and Topical View segment. And of course, on that note, we have our Topical View host, Nicolay Gunn. It is over to you now, Nicolay.
Now, our question for this month is, would you recommend work and travel to another student? Why or why not? Now, you can DM your responses to our Instagram page at Topics on the Hill, or you can send your thoughts right here in the YouTube chat at NCU TV Jamaica. Again, you can DM your responses to our Instagram page at Topics on the Hill, or you can send your responses here in our YouTube chat at NCU TV Jamaica. We'll be right back after this break.
It's small, little but Talawa. Small but packing a big punch. The DCS pins are amazing and add newness to your attire. The intricate design and creativity makes it a must-have. And how about some burgundy? Not that one, this! The new and improved DCS burgundy shirts are a must-have. You're already outstanding, so why not stand out? DCS pins cost $500, while shirts cost $3,200. Get yours at the DCS office today.
March 10th, 2020 was the day COVID-19 turned our lives upside down. But thankfully, March 10th, 2021 was the day we got hope that the pandemic will end. With the COVID-19 vaccine now being available to Jamaicans across the island, it means that very soon we can get back to normal. These vaccines are both safe and effective and will ensure that you and your loved ones are protected and can get back to the things you love most, like partying, going to church, like family dinners, like simply giving your mom or dad a hug. I have been vaccinated and I am encouraging each and every Jamaican to take the vaccine when it is available to your group. Let us put a stop to the COVID-19 pandemic. Let us get vaccinated so we can get back to life.
Listening to the top
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill. Thanks for staying with us. Now, the topic for this evening's program is the do's and don'ts of work and travel.
Now, there are many options available for tertiary students to fund their education. And of course, we have loans, we have scholarships. And as you heard just now, we have the work and travel program. Joining us this evening to speak on the do's and don'ts of work and travel, we have the Director of Career and Employment Services at NCU, Mrs. Shedige Bignall-Cuff. Good evening and welcome to Topics on the Hill, Mrs. Cuff.
Hear you. I'm not sure if you're hearing me.
Yes, we are hearing you loud.
I can't hear you, so I'm reading your lips right now.
Okay. All right,
I'm hearing you now. Awesome.
Okay.
I'm hearing you.
Wonderful. Okay. Now, let us start at the beginning. What exactly is the work and the travel program?
The work and travel program, otherwise known as the J-1 visa program, is a cultural exchange program, right, that provides students with an opportunity to live and work in the United States during their summer vacation from university in order to experience and be exposed to people and the way of life in the United States. This is the program that provides university students with the opportunity to learn more about the U.S. and share their own culture and ideas through temporary work and travel.
Speaking of temporary and stressing temporary, is it a case where once NCU gives a holiday, we can go on this program, or is there a scheduled time in the year for it?
Yeah, there's a scheduled time. It's summer. So it lasts for about 4 months during the summer period. So it's 4 months to work, and then you're granted an extra month to travel the United States and do as you will. But it's during the summer. That's why it's called the Summer Work and Travel Program.
Okay,
noted. So I know you mentioned cultural exchange as one of the things that happens when you go on work and travel. But what are some of the benefits of work and travel itself?
Listen, students, I want you to get it. Is he traveling? Traveling is all part of your education. Mm-hmm. And in education, you're being prepared to develop on your soft skills and you're learning your hard skills. And so some of the soft skills that you'll be given an opportunity to hone and develop during this time include your interpersonal skills. So those are your people skills, mm-hmm. your leadership skills, your ability to work in teams, your problem solving abilities, your time management skills, all of that, right? So the mix of people, social and professional skills coupled with your emotional intelligence and your social intelligence is becoming well valued. It's in those are wholesome nuggets to take, in my opinion, as benefits of this program.
Okay, just sounds like group dynamics and leadership to me. What are some of the required documents that students need to work in the U.S. legally?
Yeah, great question. So we're going to need a visa. Okay, we're going to need a J-1 visa in particular that is issued by the American Embassy. And that is your legal document for entering the United States. Okay, now this document, I have to stress it to young people. The document is issued with an obligation for the candidate to return home after the program finishes, okay? And the duration of the visa cannot be longer than that 4 or 5 month period. Okay, so that's one. We're going to need the visa. You're also going to need health insurance, yeah? Okay. So your work and travel agency will provide you with coverage. So you'll get health insurance, and that ought to be included in the program fee that you pay. You may have heard of the DS 2019 form. mm-hmm. as well. And that's your official certificate that will enable you, the student, to be part of this cultural exchange program. And in that form, it has the data about the program organizer, the program duration, and it specifies the point of the whole process. And that is issued by an American organization, which is the organizer of the student's stay in the United States after reception into the program. What else are you going to need? The visa, the DS-29, your health insurance. You know that you're going to have your social security number. Sorry, that's in there. You're going to have your social security number, and that number is given after the application. You've applied for it, and after you've arrived in the U.S. And in order to get that, you'll have to make sure you enclose your passport, your DS-29 team form, your J-1 visa, Paris the next one, and your I-94 form as well. Okay? And the I-94 form contains the information about the date and arrival, the date of arrival, rather, and the departure from the United States. Those are a few. Those are some, if not all. The service, those are notes. Those are constant notes. Your agencies will help you as well. Your agencies will help you.
Okay. I was just going to ask that question. But how important is it for students to do their research before going on the work and the travel program?
Trust me, it's important. Listen, you need to know which agency will best cater to your needs. Mm-hmm. Okay, which one is going to serve me best? There are a myriad of them. All right, and you need to know, listen, in my research, do I have enough funds to do a full placement? Because they can do everything for me, but you know, can I also explore self-placement? You know, those are some things you can consider as well in researching. Well, the point is, which agency is going to best suit me? And is this agency legitimate? Hello? Legitimate, important. The scammers, you know, guys,
right,
you know,
right.
Are everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And we share from our office to you guys, and I wish more of my students would just read it. And guess what? They are available to you online. Okay? Mm-hmm. The Ministry of Labor and Social Security, every few months, would publish an updated list of approved agencies. Take a note of that. Agencies that they have, that have been certified, that's important, and have been granted approval by the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. If you don't go with a legitimate agency, young people, you're
on your own. Wow.
I cannot stress it enough. They could look pretty like gold.
Mm-hmm.
Nice things. You have to make sure that they are certified to conduct business activities. Let me also add this. You have to check their affiliations. There are some agencies, to be honest, that have not gone through the Ministry of Labor and Social Security approval, but they are registered under the Jamaica Association of Employment and Cultural Exchange. The Jamaica Association of Employment and Cultural Exchange. And you'll find a host of agencies there, such as Joyce, for example. You may not see Joyce on the MLSS list, but they are here on the Jamaica Association. And I will share that with your producers later on in just a few. So you can have that to share with your viewers. What else? What are we talking about? Why is it important? You know, you need to know what the rates are. You need to know which rates, you know, aren't gonna eat you out and are affordable for you. You need to know what they're offering and just know what best suits you. Get your feedback from prior clients, your friends, you know, check their websites, all those. Do the research. It's imperative.
Thank you, Mrs. Cuff. Now, In time, we want to know, what advice would you give to a student who is actually considering the work and travel program this summer?
Listen, okay, a lot. Research your agency, make sure that your agency is legitimate. I need you to make sure that you're selecting jobs that you know will allow you to develop on your skill sets, and you know, places, and notice I'm saying places where I can add value, because you're able to work at more than one location. Okay, you're able to work over time. So that's another place. Look at the location. It's always a good idea to consider jobs that are near to where you're going to be. Consider the minimum wage. Consider how much you're going to get per hour. Consider the overtime. Those things. Your structure, your time, especially if you're considering working more than one job. You can work up to 3, 2, 3, 4 jobs, guy. Stay healthy. Boost your immune system. Create a routine for yourself. Do not run off. Do not run off. Connections with people from other cultures. Make connections. You're there. It's a cultural exchange program, okay? So that's part of your education. You're building friendships, relationships, making connections, and have fun. Set aside time to explore. Enjoy yourself. It's not just about earning enough to come back and pay your tuition and other expenses. That's good and that's important, but create a balance for yourselves. That would be my advice.
Thank you, Mrs. Vignal Kuff. I can assure you we will not be running off. We won't be running off. Thank you for coming and sharing such valuable information with us.
Thank you, guys.
Viewers, we are going to remind you of our feedback question. That is, would you recommend the work and the travel program to any other student? Why or why not? You can DM your responses to our Instagram page at Topics on the Hill, or send your thoughts in the YouTube chat at NCU TV Jamaica. At this time, we are going to a short break. We'll be right back.
The facts on dengue fever today. Unlike other diseases, dengue has different symptoms depending on the stage it is in. These include a fever of 40 degrees Celsius or higher, headache, muscle, bone, and joint pain, nausea, pain behind the eyes, rash, swollen glands, and vomiting. Combat the disease and limit the spread of the dengue fever. Use a mosquito repellent containing DEET on the skin and clothing. Sleep under a mosquito net. Keep stored water covered. Eliminate mosquito breeding sites around dwellings. Close windows before nightfall and open windows during fogging. Avoid dengue. A message from the Department of Communication Studies.
Of wearing a mask
to prevent
the spread of air droplets from persons who may or may not be infected. When wearing a mask, please ensure that the mask goes above the nose and below the chin. This might be a bit uncomfortable, but it's for your own safety. The position of the mask is very important. It should not be worn on your forehead, under your chin, or on your neck. Please do not remove the mask when speaking. This actually causes more droplets to be released into the atmosphere. Trust me, if you have on a mask, we will still hear you. When you're removing a mask, try not to touch the front of the mask. If you do, remember to wash your hands or use hand sanitizer. Please throw away the mask appropriately. Remember, partial protection is better than no protection.
Topics on the Hill, a vidcast for the students by the students. If you're just joining us, you would have missed Mrs. Shelige Bidnalkoff, and that was a fun interview. She's the Director of Career and Employment Services here at NCU, and she spoke with us about the do's and don'ts of work and travel, not running off, just assuring. Joining us now is someone who has been on the program before, and she is a third-year communication studies student here at NCU, Alia Bryant. Welcome, Alia, and thanks for coming.
No problem.
So our first question to you is, how many times have you been on the work and travel program?
Only been on the program once.
Once? And what was that experience like?
It was bittersweet. You know, waking up very, very early in the morning to go to work was always a bad start to my mornings. But when I went to work, you know, working with people from different cultures, with different backgrounds, always made it worth it. And I'd say, expect to work a lot. And you're going to encounter a lot of persons who have different personalities, but you have to remember the reason you came there, the reason you went there, and just make the best of the opportunity and have fun while working, you know? Go different places, eat different kinds of food, and just enjoy yourself.
Lovely, Alia. Sounds like you want to run off.
Not at all.
So, finally, would you recommend work and travel to tertiary students?
Yes, I would.
Let us know why.
Definitely recommend it. Of course, you know, to help your parents and yourself, you know, through school, help your relatives and whatever the case may be. And also for the experience, you know, going on this program can open a lot of doors, a lot of opportunities for you. I remember in the latter part of the program, my manager actually asked me if I could apply for the job permanently.
Look at that.
You know, so it can open a lot of doors and a lot of opportunities if you work well and, you know, deal with people well.
Definitely. Thanks, Alia, for sharing your experience.
No,
you kind of make me want to travel now.
Yes, girl.
Going to have to sign up for my J1 visa. Yeah. Thank you for coming on and giving us your experience and everything about
it.
Topics on the Hill continues after this break. Stay tuned.
ISIS Elite Fitness and Wellness is here. It is a 45-minute full-body workout that utilizes slow and controlled movements designed to break down muscles to failure so that they build back stronger and leaner. Not to mention getting rid of that stubborn fat. It's an immersive experience with energizing music, an encouraging coach, and a community of people joined together to create the strongest version of themselves.
So far, we've had killer sessions with the Phil Melodia Sports Director, Tavia Kelly, and the USM Sports Director, Zachary Berry. And we've even had encouraging and motivational sessions with past students. The workouts are intense, but the results are unbelievable.
So yeah, we had fun. You know, I lose a little belly fat. You know, I lose a little weight. Set your reminders from now so you don't have to forget. See you there every Wednesday evening on the ISIS Instagram page. Starting times may vary, so follow us on our Instagram page for updates.
Bring your towels, water, and a positive mindset.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill, a vidcast for the students by the students. Now it's time for our Peak Affairs segment, where each week we highlight a story that is trending on the local or international scene. Now, before we begin, I'm just going to say that I suffer tremendously from ranidophobia, and I think some people will get that. But if you don't, you'll understand shortly. Now, this week our story comes to us from the local media. On Tuesday night, Television Jamaica, rather, more popularly known as TVJ, shared a tweet with a photo of a frog and the caption that says, "Experts warn the Cuban tree frog is having a detrimental effect on Jamaica's environment. So if you see one, kill it. To do so, capture the frog in a scandal bag and put it in a freezer." Substances are also sold by pest control companies that kill the animal. Now, Twitter went into a frenzy after they saw that tweet, and many people expressed their fear of frogs. Others simply asked, "Whose fridge?" What are your thoughts on this, Trisha Gay? Oh, by the way, before we take Trisha Gay's thoughts, viewers, we are inviting you to share your thoughts. We want to see those responses in the YouTube chat right now. Right now. Share them. Trish, what are your thoughts?
Tristan, when I saw the tweet, the first thing that came to my mind was, are you crazy? Take up which frog and put in which freezer?
Not mine.
And then when we pull the freezer now, if we take out something, frog jump out at me? That will never happen. I don't know. Maybe. You know how when we have... like dengue going around and they send the people to do fogging, they need to get some experts to come in and look for the frogs day and night, because that's not going to happen with me.
I mean, I think the question most persons are asking, like, why? Like, is it the only way to kill the frog is by putting it in the freezer?
No, but they did mention that there are substances
sold by
pest control.
Right. But I mean, some persons are just going to want to take some salt and throw on the frog and watch it die. Why can't we explore that option? I mean, you're not the expert, but
well,
a lot of persons are wondering.
I don't know about that. Because if this thing is harmful to the environment, doesn't that mean it's harmful to me? So why would I want to even go near the frog?
Yeah.
I don't think this was something that they should have told the public to do, because our children especially may want to go and experiment. And I don't think that's safe at all for their health.
And when I was growing up, persons used to say, like, it is illogical to basically be afraid of frogs because there is nothing a frog can do to you. Mind
that
you,
is,
I really don't care about persons who say, I don't care about that thought.
Right.
I don't care about that thought. You're not going to get me to pick up a frog. And while I was doing my reading on this particular frog, I realized that there's a substance that comes from the frog that can really irritate you.
Wow.
And I don't want that to be my experience. We want to hear those responses coming in the chat. And, you know, when I heard they say it was detrimental to the environment, I realized that it basically fed on a lot of organisms within the ecosystem. So
we
it would basically decrease other organisms and that population would increase. The interesting thing I found was that the females, they laid up to 1,000 eggs.
Something that sound right.
1,000 eggs. So if those populate and they take over Jamaica, wow. We are going to be in big trouble.
Send in pest control.
But viewers, what are your thoughts? What are your thoughts on this issue? Will you catch a frog and put it in your freezer? We want to hear from you. Now, we'll be heading over to our Topical View host, Nicolay Gunn, and she will be sharing with you some of your responses, whether it be relating to these frogs or to our feedback question. Nicolay, over to you.
Thank you so much, Justin. Pardon my laugh. The chat is killing me. All right. So Danelle, she went straight ahead for Justin. She was like, Justin always making up some phobia. All right. Now, as it relates to the work experience, though, Janelle Anderson says, was a great experience. I bought my very own camera through the program. Big up yourself. Take some picture of me. All right. Then we have Danelle again. I'm a salt kill frog. Right? No, serious question. Kibishi said, with which scandal? The ones where they are, where them ban? Then Chin TV said, frogging out food for fridge. Then Danielle Martin said, then in my fridge, salt it. Danielle again said, salt is the answer. And the comment continues, food for freezer via Kelly. And the sight of them alone is terrifying, says Janelle. Now you can continue with these responses. Danielle is still typing in the chat. Mommy, I'm famous now. Okay. So you can go ahead and type in the chat. We really do look forward to these responses. These were very, very funny. I couldn't hold it back this time. Of course, you can go ahead and send your responses to our social media page at Topics on the Hill. That's on Instagram, of course. And you can type right here in the YouTube chat at NCU TV Jamaica. We still come back.
The next person in line, your friend at school or your coworker, may have COVID-19 and not know because they have no symptoms. You, on the other hand, could be hospitalized for 2 months or more if you become infected. Is it worth it? Stay socially connected, but keep the physical distance. Stay 6 feet away and avoid a hospital stay. COVID-19 is not over. Protect yourself while protecting others. A message from the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
One in every four women will be a victim of domestic violence. 1.3 million women each year will be abused by an intimate partner. Your life is not worth the gamble. Ladies, speak up. Don't allow
anyone to
silence you. Is not worth the gamble. Ladies, speak up. Don't allow him to silence you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Topics on the Hill. Now we are going straight into our Stars on the Hill segment. And of course, NCU full of talented people, good up people. So this evening is no different. We are joined by the president of the Phil Melodia Club. I don't say pronounce, no, it's Phil Melodia, yeah? Phil Melodia Club, Savannah Matthews. Good evening, Savannah, and welcome.
Good evening, Tristan. Hi, everyone.
No, she made it clear that she is not nervous. Like, this is nothing for her. We want to know, who is Savannah Matthews?
All right. Hi, everyone. As you said before, my name is Savannah Matthews, mm-hmm. and I am the president of one of the best clubs on campus, and that is the Female Loader Club. I'm a senior. My major is human resources, and mm-hmm. I would like to say that I'm a very hardworking and persistent person. So that's just a little synopsis of who I am.
Yeah. Guys, she did not say she was the president of the best club. She said she was the president of one of the best clubs.
We share it.
Right?
We share it.
Right? Yeah. Good. Now, how do you balance being president of Phil Melodia and schoolwork?
I would want to say prioritize because that's the best answer, but I'm not going to lie, I don't. Phil Melodia is something that I really love and it's taken over my life. So you know that when they say that if you truly love something, you never work a day in your life. That's what Phil Melodia is for me. So if most of my exec members, they're my friends. Mm-hmm. So if you ask them what the conversation is about 90% of the time, it's definitely Phil Melodia. But I try my best to prioritize.
And, okay.
Yeah.
In your role as president, what has been your favorite project to date?
I don't want to be biased because I was going to say all of them. Mm-hmm. But all right, so some of the individual projects that we've done that I really love, you know, of course, our Baby Versus. And okay. I would say the welcoming treat that we had the other day. This is where the exec members came together. And we just served the ladies ice cream. We did TikToks, we fellowship. We just talked and had like those conversations with the actual ladies on both the Auxiliary and Jamaica Hall. And I think my favorite collab, I know you said one. But mm-hmm. then my favorite collab has to be our collab with Misty Blue Foundation and Taylor Hall. So yeah, when we did our breast cancer seminar. And of course, my collabs with my favorite clubs, Basel, mm-hmm. Rotaract, Excelsior, of course. So yeah.
What has this position, this role done for you as a person? How has it developed you as a person?
I was a very tuned person at first. So to be here today.
Hold on.
Yeah, all right, sorry.
Got that again for me, please.
I was a very timid person.
Timid?
Yeah.
Wow. So before being president, mm-hmm. you were not this confident.
No.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I want to be president of a club right now. You can continue.
I would say a big thanks to the past president, that's Danny Walker. We were close together. I was mm-hmm. her VP. She really encouraged me, you know, helped me through some stuff when I didn't really have much confidence.
Yeah.
So she helped me to grow. And a female leader, of course, every single lady in female leader, regardless of their personality, you learn from them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you know, it's a team more than a group. So you learn from each person in the team. So yeah, it helped me to build my confidence and it helped me to be the person I am today, the president.
Wow. Finally, mm-hmm. Savannah, what advice do you have for a student right now who is listening, who does not feel that he or she has the skills or what it takes to be a leader?
One thing that I would say is that leaders are made. What is for you will always be for you.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, if it's God will, it will happen. So first, I would say put God first.
Yeah.
Then secondly, if you want it, go for it. So be mm-hmm. hardworking and be persistent. And thirdly, I would say believe in yourself. So put God first, be persistent, and believe in yourself, basically.
Wow. Thank you so much for joining us today, Savannah. There you have it, viewers, the president of the Phil Melodia Club here at NCU, Miss Savannah Matthews. Now, we are going to be going to a short break. We will be right back.
Of pale green and gray, nowhere in the suburbs, in the cold light of day, there in the midst of it, so alive and alone, words support like bone, dreaming of mercy Street, where you're inside out, dreaming of mercy.
Back to Topics on the Hill. The United Student Movement is the governing student body of the Northern Caribbean University. The 2021-2022 regime has been working non-stop to serve the students as best as possible, and we have seen that. Do you know your USM members? Let's find out together on Meet the USM.
Hi everybody, my name is Alia Mogowan. I am the Vice President of Finance and Planning for the United Student Movement 2021 to 2022 regime.
Yes, my name is Giovanni Baker. I am the Associate Public Relations Officer for the United Students Movement.
Hey guys, my name is Alexis Hunnigan and I am the Treasurer for USM.
So my role basically is to oversee, maintain, and manage the assets of the movement.
Well, I manage the money along with my VP of finance.
My role as the associate PRO is to basically develop and to maintain the image and form relationships with the students and the public of the USM.
Well, my favorite is learning, because every day you learn something. So you might think you know it all, but you don't. Trust me, you don't. My least, I should say, I don't think I have a least at the moment.
Well, basically, I love everything about my position, but one thing is that it's very time consuming.
It's really just to form relationships, you know, public relations, getting to know people, getting to understand the problems, and, you know, finding a solution to help the relationships to get better. The least favorite? Oh, probably trying to remember to post certain things. Yeah, as I'm getting old. Yes. Team would focus more on doing rather than showing. Showing is important, but if you're not doing the work that you're supposed to be doing, it will be lying, and we don't want to be dishonest with our publics. We want to be honest at all times. So keep it honest, do the right thing, and after you do the right thing, you show what you have been doing. And that is a fundamental PR tip.
I would say to make sure that you really want to be a part of USM and you want to represent the students. That's basically it.
Be prepared. Be prepared. It is time consuming and you have to have proper time management.
Surprise, well, I'm an introvert, so most persons will say that, you know, I'm shy and timid, but really I'm a jokester, I like to make fun.
Favorite drink of ginger beer. I feel like the best juice that we got ever. Want a surprise?
I am a socializer. Yeah, when persons get to know me, they realize that, you know, I have a buzz, you know? So most persons think that I'm an introvert and I'm shy. No, hop around on one foot.
A cat.
Why?
Because they have 9 lives.
Riddles, like Raymond Reddington.
On the hill, NCU.
I would tell them to.
All you need to know. Come learn about your school and be in the know about. The current affairs, if there is ever a time that you're in doubt, topics on the hill is here.
There's absolutely more to the USM members than we know. And as Gio said, I think we're all getting old. Yes. We wrap things up on the other side of this break, or final break, actually. Stay with us. Topics on the Hill returns.
Topics on the Hill.
The next person in line, your friend at school or your co-worker, may have COVID-19 and not know because they have no symptoms. You, on the other hand, could be hospitalized for 2 months or more if you become infected. Is it worth it? Stay socially connected, but keep the physical distance. Stay 6 feet away and avoid a hospital stay. COVID-19 is not over. Protect yourself while protecting others. A message from the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
One in every four women will be a victim of domestic violence. 1.3 million women each year will be abused by an intimate partner. Your life is not worth the gamble. Ladies, speak up. Don't allow him to silence you.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill. Earlier we asked the feedback question, would you recommend the work and travel program to another student? Why or why not? Let's go to Nicolay, who will be sharing the final responses for this evening's program.
Thank you so much, Trish. Now, we have quite a number of responses, and some of them are pretty lengthy, so let's get right into it. Yes, you gain new experiences, learn new culture, meet new people, feel good to earn in US dollars. Another person said, you gain a new sense of responsibility and work ethic because the work environment is different in the United States. Also, you have a sense of independence. Another person says, I would definitely recommend work and travel to another student because it gives the experience one should get. You widen your cultural experience, and is a plus when you actually save your money. Come back to JA and change it out with this high exchange rate. Who not gonna love that? That was Kibishi. Now, another user says it's subjective. If you think you need the money more than you need summer school, then by all means, go for it. It's a good financial opportunity when you are disciplined. Interesting. If you're not disciplined, it's genuinely a waste of money. Now, Alia did make that clear in her interview that you need to get up early mornings. All right. Now, Eralisa Shaw said, yes and no. Before anyone goes on the J1 program, they need to calculate the cost. Calculate your income, rent, expenses, etc. to see if your trip will be feasible. Also, check if your job offers overtime. Be that you will be making money, right? You're going there to make money. Moreover, check the location to see what hotels, restaurants, business places that are close by. And Mrs. Cuff stated that you can work more than one job. This way, you can see if they have vacancies so that you can get a second job. Trust me, when I say you won't make enough of one job alone, you have to bring out your inner hustler, all right? The one you never knew you had, that same one. Overall, it's a good experience, especially if you have never had a job before. You do get to meet other J1 students from across the globe and get to learn new things. It can be exciting. Plus, there's shopping. I would love that. So it's a plus. Additionally, you can build professional relationships with employers, which can earn you job opportunities. Thank you so much for your responses. Oh, we have one more here on Instagram. And this is the final one. Yes, I would recommend everyone to participate in the work and travel program. Participating in this program assists you to meet others from different culture backgrounds and to share your own culture. If you are having issues monetarily, there are a lot of agencies who assist financially. All right, that sounds like some hope. I might go on it next year. Who knows? Thank you so much for sharing your responses. This month was actually a good one for me. I enjoyed especially the YouTube chat. Thank you so much, guys, for participating. Over to you, Trisha Gay and Tristan.
Thank you so much, Nicolie. Now, just like that, we are at the end of today's episode of Topics on the Hill. And what an interesting episode it was. Now, we'll be giving you a short recap just in case you missed a part of today's program. Now, of course, we had the interview with Mrs. Scott, right? Yes. You can brief them about what that is, Trish.
Yes, so I made my notes. Mrs. Scott, you will be proud of me. Yes, so I know she said it lasts for approximately 4 months and you get an extra month to travel and tour the U.S., as well as the benefits of it is getting get to bring out your leadership skills and, you know, the cultural exchange and meeting new people and all of that. Yeah. And the biggest don't is don't run off. We're not stressing it. We can't stress it enough. Do not run off. Mm-hmm. But however, you need to check for scammers, ensure that the program you're going with is legitimate,
right?
And nobody don't thief your money and then you cry and you can't go anywhere because that's double negative right there. Remember some stuff you need to have: your J1 visa, your DS-29 form, passport, you're getting your I-94 form. Yeah, those are a few things that she spoke about, and most importantly, have fun. As Abigail would have said, would have said earlier to us, have fun while working. Yeah.
And of course, we can get some more information from her and her office. She is the Director of Career and Employment Services here at NCU. And of course, we had our Stars on the Hill segment. We heard from Adia Bryant, who experienced the Work and the Travel program. Mm-hmm. And we also heard from Savannah Matthews, who is the president of one of the best clubs on campus, the Phil Melodia Club. And that was just about it. Before we go, we are going to wish our executive producer and director of publications, Rasheed Nangle, and her sister, who is the VP of Spiritual Affairs, a very, very happy, happy birthday. You said you looked like 13, but I think they more looked like 13, you know?
That's okay.
They look very young, and they're, well, happy, happy birthday, guys. I don't want to get in any trouble. Happy, happy, happy birthday. We also had our Peak Affairs segment.
The frog.
Right, and you learned a new phobia this evening, Rani. The phobia, the fear of frogs. I know a lot of you guys suffer from that as well. I'm not alone.
We want to thank our viewers as well, Tristan, for staying tuned and for coming out this evening and supporting us. We hope you enjoyed the program. Yeah. So remember, Topics on the Hill is now aired every fourth Thursday, at 6 p.m. on NCU TV Jamaica. And the next episode will be aired on February 24, and it promises to be something to look forward to. Not only that, look forward to the Get to Know Me live sessions on Instagram on Sundays at 7 p.m. I know Tristan went last week. Tristan, what
was that? That was awesome. That was awesome. I mean, the guys who joined, not guys like males who joined, but the individuals who joined that live, everybody had fun, and it's basically a get to know me, as in the hosts of Topics on the Hill. It's a get to know me feature. I enjoyed it, and it showed me that I really don't know some things about myself.
Wow.
Which is kind of bad, but I'm happy for that. It's a learning process, and you guys will learn more about us as the hosts of Topics on the Hill. Awesome.
Told you, something to look forward to. We want to thank Nicolay Gunn, our Topical View host, for the excitement and for managing social media for us. We also want to thank our production team, our producer, Khadija, big up yourself, for everybody right here supporting me. Thank you. And Tristan, thank you.
Yeah.
For the technical team behind the scenes, thank you. We cannot stress it enough.
I think we can give Trisha Gay her props. She actually did well for today.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. We can give her. Yeah. Yeah. Amoy would be proud.
Love that.
No, this has been Topics on the Hill.
A vidcast for the students by the students. I'm Trisha Gay Kelly.
And I'm Tristan Grizzle.
Good evening.
Topics on the Hill. NCU, Topics on the Hill, all you need to know about NCU. Come learn about your school. Hey. know about your current affairs. If there is ever a time that you're in doubt, Topics on the Hill is here.
Listening to Topics on the Hill.
Topics on the Hill is here. Topics on the Hill.